dream come true turned into a nightmare for a local family. A mother of four who hit the lottery with a winning scratcher ticket during the pandemic is now the victim of a murder-suicide.
Police say her husband is the gunman who also killed their little daughter. CBS 13's Steve Large is live in Calaveras County with the investigation so far on this. Steve?
Yeah, and this is the Valley Springs store where this mother bought this winning lottery ticket. And you can still see on the front door here, they are celebrating that winning ticket. It reads Valley Springs Mini Market Instant Prize Crossword $2 million. What an incredible moment in life. This mother packed up everything. Her husband, her children moved to Oklahoma. Since then, everything went tragically wrong. A lottery millionaire murder-suicide. Photos show 31-year-old Tiffany Hill surrounded by family and her precious children. Police say she was shot and killed in a murder-suicide by her husband, John Donato, shown here, who also killed their one-year-old daughter. The deadly encounter unfolding inside this Oklahoma home where the whole family had just moved from Calaveras County after the lottery win. The Hill family attorney says Hill had described being in an abusive relationship and she wanted out.
Tiffany never reached out to me about anything of that nature, but I did speak with her mom, and her mom wants the message that Tiffany was trying to get away from it.
Her attorney also questioned the role the millions played in the deadly attack.
Could that have sparked that argument? And we'll never have any way of knowing. But I do know there were times that caused conflict between them.
Hill's sister describes her as a dreamer whose passion was her children and animals. That family is now working to get the three surviving children back to California. Lottery money will be put in a trust for them. The family is seeking help for funeral arrangements. A tragic end for a millionaire mother who had just hit the jackpot, never able to fulfill the dreams of her new financial reality. And Hill's surviving children were in the home at the time of the attack. They are 11, 9, and 7 years old.
Ah, so sad. Steve, thank you. Live in Calaveras County tonight.